In this video, we're going to talk about outliers. Definition: an outlier are data, value, or values that lie outside of the overall pattern of the distribution. What does this mean? So think of distribution as a picture of your data. And let's say you're collecting data through some type of dot plot, and you notice some points that don't conform to the overall pattern, right? To the overall picture, to the overall distribution. And you might think, hey, these could be outliers. By looking at it, it does look like they don't conform to the overall pattern. But there's a math way to figure out if these are outliers. What we're going to do is we're going to calculate something called the upper bound value. And when we do this, any value above the upper bound value, we're going to consider that an outlier. On the other side, the same thing. We're going to calculate something called the lower bound value. Anything below that, we're going to consider any data points to be outliers. Let's do an example to figure out how to do this. So let's say I have these data points, and I also have the 5-number summary. You're always going to need the 5-number summary on these data points. If you don't know how to do that, not a problem. I got a video for you that you can watch. Okay, the first thing we need to do is to calculate IQR. Again, we're trying to figure out if any of my data points are outliers. So I need to calculate this IQR, which is the interquartile range, and that's going to equal to Q3 take away Q1, and I have those values right there. So I'm going to write them down: 73 take away 65, and that's going to equal to 8. Okay, not a problem. I'm going to need that value. Let's calculate the upper bound value. That has a formula: Q3 plus 1.5 times IQR. 1.5 is always going to be there. IQR, you have to calculate, which we already did. Q3, we have that value with our 5-number summary. Okay, let's plug it in. Q3 is 73 plus 1.5 times 8. And 1.5 times 8, I believe, is 12. So 73 plus 12 equals 85. Note that the upper bound value, the formula has a plus sign, Q3 plus 1.5, okay? So 73 plus 12 gives you 85. All right, let's move on. Let's look at the lower bound value, and we'll look at the formula first. That's going to be Q1 take away 1.5 times IQR. Notice that this one has a subtraction. Q1, we already have in our 5-number summary. 1.5, that's automatic. IQR, we calculated already. Let's plug it in. 65 take away 1.5 times 8, that's going to be what? That's right, 65 take away 12, which equals 53. So again, upper bound value formula has a plus sign, lower bound value formula has a takeaway sign. Okay. So, any data values not falling between 53 through 85 are suspected to be outliers. So, between 53 through 85, any data points that go in there, we don't consider them outliers. Any data values that go outside, below 53 or above 85, are considered outliers. In this data set, do you consider any points to be outliers? That's right, 90. 90 is a possible outlier. So what we do is we can draw a box plot to show that there is an outlier. We want to do is we want to draw a number line, and then in the way I do it, I'll draw a dot for the minimum, I'll draw a dot for Q1, another dot for the median, another dot for Q3. And we know we can't use 90 for the max because that's an outlier. So we're going to get rid of that, and we're going to consider the next highest, which will be 74. And so I'm going to put a dot for 74 there. And I'm going to put a star above 90 because that's going to tell everybody, hey, there's an outlier here. Next thing I want to do is draw a box, right? That's going to be, basically, that's my IQR, right? That's going to be my Q1, median, Q3. Okay. And then I draw the whiskers. And that's it. I got my box plot. Now, if you want more information on how to draw a box plot, go ahead and watch my video.